Hey everybody, it's Jason Blaha here, and today I ask the question, how strong is strong enough? And I also ask the question of, have I been too aggressive in the past with my stance of the strength standards I expect of people? Are they always reasonable? Are they maybe too much for a lot of people? And you know what? I'm actually man enough to admit that I may have been wrong there in many cases. Yeah, I've pushed some pretty aggressive standards for people when I was a competitive strength athlete competing in powerlifting because I had that mindset. And you know what? I think there's a lot of cases to where the standards that I pushed maybe were a little bit too much for a lot of people. Maybe they were excessive. Maybe I was potentially setting people up for injury, and I actually hope that no one did get injured because they were trying to meet my strength standards or the strength standards that anyone else put out there for them based upon whatever their reasons were. Because you know what? At the end of the day, it's really no one else's business to determine for you unless you have hired them as a coach to coach you through something in a professional environment. They really have no business setting strength standards for you. Let's just be honest about that. Now, I still stick by the standards I set for my novice program in the sense of I think at least half of people running that program, if they follow the program to the letter, do it the way that I say they're going to do it, and they don't have any extenuating health circumstances, injuries, or things like that going on, I think a pretty large number of people, up to about half of people, maybe more, can reach those standards on that program. However, are they going to get much stronger after that? Probably not. They're going to slow down dramatically because they've gone through most of their lifetime drug-free gains at that point. That program was designed to milk those out. However, I also have said that the program will bury a lot of people. Like one in four people cannot even recover from the program. It's a very aggressive program. That's why I have others out there. So yeah, my standards have been pretty strict in the past, including what I've set as lifetime natural goals. So the question I ask is, what are your strength standards? How strong do you personally need to be to reach your overall fitness goals? And that's a question I've had to reevaluate with myself as I'm starting to get older. I mean, I had goals that I set when I was competing in powerlifting, but now I'm going on 40. I'm going to turn 40 this year. I want to be healthy and fit. I want to be strong. I sure as hell don't want to be weak. I don't want to be as weak as the average person, not even close. I don't ever want to fall out of the top 1% for my age bracket. I'm not willing to do that. But how strong do I personally need to be to reach my goals? Well, I've set a number for me that may not be appropriate for you. I've decided for myself that I don't want my deadlift, my raw beltless, strapless deadlift, to fall under 500 pounds. Not 5 years from now, not 10 years from now. Hopefully, cross my fingers, not 20 years from now. Now, that's asking a lot, though, to 20 years from now to still be deadlifting that. Be 60 years old and deadlift 500 pounds? Maybe I'm being too aggressive here. But I've had to ask that because I look at it and say, okay, well, how much stronger do I really need to be? I mean, I can do 530 pounds for 4 or 5 reps without a belt, without straps. How much stronger do I need to be to stay fit, healthy, and strong and not hurt myself to reach my other goals? Because I have things I want to do later in life. There are certain goals I'm starting to set for myself. I'm not, you know, discussing them with anyone else outside of my loved ones, but there are certain things I'm looking at doing in the future I would like to do physically, maybe even competitively. I need to be in shape. I can't afford to have the active lifestyle I want to have if I get a major injury. If I try to push myself and get to where I'm deadlifting 650 or 700 pounds or something like that, I am predisposing myself to injuries that might actually hurt my goals. And you know what? Every coach and every professional athlete out there who has their athletes train for strength training, even if they get them brutally strong, they have goals they set of how strong does my athlete, my football player, my rugby player, my MMA fighter, how strong do they need to be on these lifts in order to get the strength and power that I need for them to have in a competitive environment without it interfering with their recovery from other things, without it greatly increasing their chance of injury that will take them out of competition or, you know, even reduce their quality of life. That's the question those coaches ask, and that's something that all of us need to step back and ask for ourselves. Being strong is great. Strength is never a weakness. Most of us out there should strive to get stronger. It's a good thing. It has a lot of uses. However, we also need to step back and go, how strong is strong enough to have the real world strength that you're going to need to do the physical endeavors that you set out to do? Because the vast majority of people out there listening on YouTube are not competitive strength athletes. They're not competing in strongman. They're not competing in powerlifting, Olympic lifting, things like that. A lot of them want to get stronger so that they can improve at other things, so they can be healthy, they can be fit, they can be useful in real world scenarios. So they don't have those, I must be as strong as humanly possible for my weight class or just overall if I don't have a weight class. They don't think like that. They need to think in terms of, well, I should probably get stronger. It'd be a good thing if I can still definitely get stronger. I should do so if I can do so without injuring myself, if I can do so without impeding my recovery that affects the other things that I want to do. Maybe they enjoy doing golf tournaments competitively. Maybe they play amateur tennis competitively. Maybe they do three-gun competition competitively. There's things that people do. Maybe they're really avid hunters. There's a lot of physical activities that people need to do that the fitness from strength training can absolutely tremendously carry over to, but can also even reduce their chances of getting hurt and make them better at these things that they want to do. But they have to factor in the risk factors of pushing themselves too hard and doing too much in the gym. Is it going to injure them? And if they get injured, can they still do the things that they want to do, or have they just damaged their quality of life and stopped themselves from being able to do the things that they really and truly want to do that make them happy and bring them joy in their life as well? And I think all of us should find something physical that we really do that we enjoy enough to maybe even consider doing at an amateur competitive level. And I think that applies to any age group, because if we want to be fit and we want to be healthy, I think competition, at least at the lower levels, can absolutely facilitate improved fitness. It's usually the upper echelons of sports to where they become dangerous. And so we all need to step back and go, well, how strong do I need to be? Will a 300-pound deadlift be enough? Hey, I mean, if it's tennis or golf, it very well might be, but you'd have to ask, will a 400-pound deadlift help me swing that club a little faster? That's what you have to weigh out. Can I get to that 400-pound deadlift without pulling a hamstring or injuring myself or hurting my back? And will it still help me? And is it a reasonable goal? Can I reasonably get to that goal if I put in the time and work without hurting myself? Something like 400, probably so. For the vast majority of healthy men, unless they're getting a lot older, probably reasonable. Again, given the time frame to do so, if they're willing to put in enough time, and it's going to take some longer than others. Is a 500 reasonable? Well, maybe not for everyone. That's what I've set for myself. Maybe 500 might be too aggressive for you. Maybe it's going to, the recovery from it's going to interfere with your other lifestyle and your profession. Maybe because if you're a smaller framed guy, that getting to that 500 because you're a little bit shorter and than I am and not quite my height, it's going to require more work and more muscle mass. It's going to have a higher injury risk for that person. So for them, if it's not really essential for what they're trying to do, maybe the risk is too high. And that's what each and every one of us have to ask for ourselves. Because sure, if you're going to go compete in powerlifting, yeah, you want your deadlift to be as high as humanly possible, particularly for your weight class. That should be your goal if you're competing. But I've also seen a lot of guys who I competed with in powerlifting hit the last meet that I did, the Nationals in the UK, a guy who beat me, who won my class, because it was a really stacked class. It was a really, really big class. A guy who beat me, very next meet, he tore bicep, had to have surgery. A guy who was ranked below me also injured himself, had to have a major surgery, bicep repaired. So two guys who were at the last meet I was at in my class, one who beat me and one who lost against me, they have both torn biceps. They've had injuries. They've hurt themselves. So it's also asking the question of, as you start to get older, particularly as you start to get older, up into your 30s, 40s, is even that competitive goal? You need to weigh out, is it going to beat your body up too much? Is it worth it to you personally? I can't answer that for you. Those are the questions that we all need to ask. We need to ask those questions. Is the joy that I get out of that competition going to be worth the risk to me of the worst case scenarios of what could go wrong? And if maybe not, then you need to reevaluate, can I train differently? Can I do better deloading? Can I change the way I'm doing things to cut down that risk dramatically of that injury while still striving for that goal? Because that should always be your fallback position if you're worried about it at all, and you should be worried about those things. And if that's an option for you, then hey, great. Change the way you're training, cut the risk, and push forward to that goal. Win. Be a champion. But if it really isn't worth it to you and you think it's going to reduce your quality of life, maybe back out of competition and just train for your quality of life. Train for something else. You can always find a different competitive endeavor that will make you happy. And I think all of us can find these things if we look around. We can find competitive endeavors that make us happy. And we need to step back and ask, how strong do I need to be for those endeavors that I want to undertake, for the physical endeavors that I want to undertake? What's the strongest I can get away with without probably hurting myself is the first question we should ask. And then ask, how strong do I need to be at the minimal? And you're usually going to find the balance somewhere between those two. And that's that sweet spot somewhere in there that you need to look for, is striking that balance between what's the minimum strength I think I'm going to need to do the things that I want to do effectively, and what's the strongest I think I can get without injuring myself. And in between those two is always going to be your sweet spot. All right, guys, but that's really all I have to say on that today. I hope it's been informative, and I will talk to you guys next time.